Tune into this week's Xamarin Essential API of the Week, where I show off the brand new permissions API to check and request permissions from a single line of code. Tune in. Welcome back, everyone, to Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Today, I'm really excited to show off a brand new API in Xamarin Essentials 1.5, which is the permissions API. I love this one because it enables you as a developer to easily check and request permissions from your users with just a few lines of code. So let's head over to Visual Studio and get started. Now, of course, I'm over here in Visual Studio, and I go into my NuGet packages, and I have Xamarin Essentials installed. This brand new permissions API was introduced in 1.5, so make sure you update Xamarin Essentials accordingly. Now, what's really great about this is I've installed it into my iOS, Android, Windows, and my shared project, but actually, to use permissions, you can do it all from shared code. I, of course, recommend heading over to our documentation over here, your Getting Started Guide. You'll need to do a little bit of setup if you are integrating Xamarin Essentials into an existing application. And of course, for any new application, it's already installed. Now, permissions is actually really, really nice. It's a very, very simple API to check and request permissions. So here, for example, if I want to check a permission, I can say check status async, and I pass it the permission I want to check. Over here, I can request permission async and pass it in the permission as well. It will return back an enum, whether it's been denied, granted, or restricted. And I can check a flurry of different permissions. Now, we have this big grid here to specify what is support on Android, iOS, Windows, Watch, tvOS, and Tizen as far as permissions go. But it's important that even though one is not supported, it may just not be required. For example, the flashlight API, there's no permission needed to turn on and off the flashlight where Android there is. So make sure you read the platform-specific implementation documentation of what permissions you actually need. But let's go ahead and take a look at our App Essentials app. Now, in a previous video, we showed off the geolocation API. And this is really cool because, again, from a few lines of code, you can get and request geolocation. Now, this API under the hood will automatically check the permissions and request the permissions for you using the permissions API, but let's do it manually anyways. So over here, I'm gonna say permissions, and I'll say permissions dot, and let's go ahead and zoom in here. Now here we can see all of the different permissions that I have available to me to request, and there's two methods in here, check and request. So let's first check the permission. And this here is generic, and it takes in a permission, so T permission. And those are all those permissions that we saw earlier. So over here what I'll do is simply say permissions.location. And there's location always and location when in use. Now, this application is using the geolocation API, which is only when in use. So let's go ahead and use that one. And there we go. You can check and request a single permission at a time. Now, what's really important is that under the hood here on my Android application, we have ensured that we've added the permissions for fine and coarse. And that's really, really important because when that check or request is going through, it's going to validate your info plist, your app manifest, or your assembly information or Android manifest here. So when you're using a native integration, make sure you declare that you're going to be using that permission. So here I'll say if permissions does not equal, and here what I'm going to get back after I wait on it, of course, is an enum permission status. And if it's not granted, then I'm gonna go ahead and request it. So again, I'll say permissions, and then I'll say await permissions dot, and this time I'm going to request async. And again, I'll just say permissions dot location when in use, and there we go. Now at this point, I've checked it, I've requested it, and if for some reason permissions do not equal permission status.granted, then I probably want to return out of this and pop up a dialog box. But let's add some breakpoints here and follow along in the code to see what actually happens. So let's go here, add a bunch of breakpoints, and hit debug. So what this will do in just a few lines of code is check our status, make sure to see if the user has granted it or not, and then actually requested it. And this is going to be the first time I use the permission on this device, so I should get prompted here. So here we go. It's gone ahead and launched. And we're inside of the geolocation page, so let's go ahead and open that one up. There we go. Geolocation. And I'll say get location. Now we'll minimize down the emulator, and we'll first see when I check permission that it is denied. On Android, the default is a denied state. On iOS and Windows, it is in an unknown state. So you want to be aware of those differences there. So it's been denied because it hasn't been granted yet. So we're going to go through and we're going to request asynchronously. And we get this dialog box. This dialog box might look a little different based on your Android operating system, and same with iOS. But here it's asking that App Essentials needs the device location. I'm going to say allow when in use. Now when I come back over, I can see that this permission right there has been granted. That's it. We can go back here, and now I can actually see that I got the geolocation because I have permission and I didn't get prompted again. Now, if the user revokes that permission, it will go ahead and prompt it again. Important information here, though, is that on iOS, if a user ever denies or revokes a permission, that pop-up won't come back again. And when you request it, it will just come back in a denied state. So some additional logic that I would put in here is to say, if after I request, it's still been denied, tell my user to go to the settings and turn on that permission, and then your application can resume. Check out the documentation for a real in-depth guide on how to work with permissions, as while this makes it super easy to check, they still can be a little bit tricky. But I hope that you really enjoyed this beautiful brand new API to check and request permissions from just a few lines of code. Now don't forget to ding that bell, subscribe, and do all the things that I tell you at the end of every video. And I hope that you enjoy this Essential API of the Week, and thanks for watching. Hey, it's James. I'm just checking in and wanted to thank you for watching this awesome Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Now, don't forget to do all the things, such as like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell for even more videos. And while you're here, check out more Xamarin Essential API videos of the week. They're all right here. Go do it right now. It's awesome.